I need a little more noise than that. Can I hear the candidate? Can we get some more noise? Can I? Look, I'll tell you what, in the Seahawks organization, at the Seahawks organization, we have a motto. It's called compete. We competing in everything that we do. Do we got some Seahawks fans in here? Make some noise. Yeah. My man Bill looks. I want this side to say C. I want this side to say Hawks. I'm telling you what, I play in front of thousands of people, and sometimes I can't even hear myself talk, so I want to hear it. So this side's going to say C, this side's going to say Hawks. Ready? I did not come back to my alma mater to be that loud. I've been to 5 different high schools already, and they were way louder than that. So we're gonna try this again. We're gonna try it again. This side right here, ready? Hold on, guys. What is this, the juniors? Are this the juniors and the seniors? Seniors? This is all seniors? So y'all the cool ones, huh? Yeah. Y'all could be louder than them. I know ain't that many people over here. Y'all could be louder than that. So can we try again? Can we try again? All right. You guys are doing great. Let's see if the cool guys can be better. Ready? Here we go. See, now that's a lot better. That's a lot better. So, my name is Jermaine Kearse. I'm a wide receiver for the Seattle Seahawks. I'm going on my 6th year. It's been a blessing to be able to play in the NFL for 6 years because the average is only 3 years. So I've been able to double the time to play in the NFL. I graduated from Lakes High School in 2008. Thank you. And I want to say it's an honor to be here, to be able to come talk to you guys, to be able to encourage, to lift, inspire, whatever I can to help you guys out, to reach the potential that you guys are able to reach. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Don't worry, I got my phone out just in case I get off track, so. What was that?
Add you on the snap.
I'll add you on the snap? Look, hey, I'll tell you what, I have no problem going off script talking, so. I grew up literally right down the street from here. I lived here for about 24 years. Lived in Washington pretty much my whole life. I grew up in Lakewood. I went here, I've experienced it all. And I just want to thank you guys for allowing me to come here and be able to talk. So if there was one thing I would name this, I wouldn't call it a lecture because you guys probably just got out of class, so I don't want to lecture you guys. But if there's one thing I would call this talk or this speech or whatever you want to call it, it would be called Be the Best You. It'll call it Be the Best You, and you're probably sitting there wondering, what does that mean, Be the Best You? So at the Seahawks, in our organization, Pete always talks about before games, Saturday night, at the hotels, he's always talking about, we don't need you to do more out of yourself, we just need you to be the best you. So I thought about that. I look over at Doug Baldwin to my left, and I always ask him this every time. He gets annoyed by it. I'm like, Doug, are you the best you? And he looks at me and like, stop asking me that. And so I thought about that, be the best you. How can I take being the best me playing football in my profession and take it into real life? So I thought about how can I incorporate this in real life? How can I make this happen? So when I think about being the best me, I think about being opportunistic. I think about making the most of opportunities and trying to do the best I can with them. So when I think about those opportunities, in order to make the most of those opportunities, you gotta have a plan. So in that plan, I want to talk about investments, right? You hear about investments, investing your money, investing your time. Well, one of the biggest investments you guys can make in your whole life is investing in yourself. And what does that mean, investing in yourself? Is being able to take the opportunities you have and just make the most of them. Whether that's having a plan of being to school on time, it's important. The little things count. Our motto this year is everything counts. Everything counts, everything that we do, every small detail, every opportunity we get, everything counts. So whether that's coming to school on time, whether that's actually just coming to school, all you gotta do is show up. That's the first step. That's the easiest step, is just being able to show up. Show up to school. There's a lot of talking. I wanna know these conversations. What y'all talking about? Shoes? I don't know what that is. Okay, now we're gonna get back on track. Back on track. Being the best you, guys. Being the best you is having a plan, investing in yourself. When I mean investing in yourself, you gotta have a plan. You guys, talking about setting goals. You're probably sitting in there, you're probably thinking like, he's talking about setting goals. I've been hearing about this my whole life. Setting goals, long-term, short-term. I heard about it, tired of hearing about it. But let me tell you a thing, it's a real thing. And let me tell you why setting goals is important. Setting goals is important because when you set goals, you create a purpose. When you create a purpose, you create energy for that purpose. And that's important because when you create that purpose, now you have a reason of doing something. So when you set these long-term and short-term goals, now you have a reason of doing something. Now when you get to the end of your task or your goal or whatever you're doing, is you're not sitting there thinking about, okay, why did I just do that? What was the point of that? When you set these goals, now you have a reason. And I'm telling you, you might really think it sounds crazy, you might think it's cool, but I'm telling you, I've been in your position before, and I'm almost been 10 years out of high school. And I sit back and I look about all the things that I did in high school, and I was happy that I did, because I'm telling you right now, you might not see it right now, but it matters. I'm telling you, life goes by quick. It goes by quick, and it's gonna go right before you. I'm telling you, these 6 years in the NFL felt like I was just in my rookie year last year. They go by quick. Take advantage. It's important. It's important. I'm telling you right now, I can't stress enough how fast it's gonna go. You might not think it's important right now. A lot of you guys are about to go into college. A lot of you guys are probably just entering high school. But I'm telling you, when you get to my age and when you get to further beyond that, it's important. It's gonna go by fast, and you're gonna realize about the opportunities that you created and that you made the most of, and the opportunities that you passed and missed and didn't take advantage of. It's important. I can't stress that enough. The next thing is when you actually go back. So people used to always ask me, people still ask me, why do I walk fast everywhere I go? I'm like I'm literally like speed walking every time. And they ask me like, why are you walking? I'm just like, I walk with a purpose. When I go somewhere, I walk with a purpose. I got a task, I'm gonna walk. My wife never takes me shopping. She never takes me to the mall. She says I ruin it, the experience of shopping. Because when I go in, I have a task. I'm going to go in, I'm gonna get what I need, and I'm getting out. My wife, she likes to go in, she likes to try things on. That's not me. She says I ruined the experience, so I don't go. And the reason why I walk fast is because when we were in the mall, my mom used to walk really fast, and when I was young, I used to have to like run behind her to keep up. Little did I know, she was training me for the NFL when I didn't even know. So I appreciate that. But move it. Everything has a purpose. What you do has a purpose. Creating a purpose, creating goals creates a purpose that creates energy. Now with that, everybody in this gym has a purpose. Everybody in this gym has a gift. If you don't think you do, you're lying to yourself, you do. The most important thing I want you guys to know though is not everybody's gift and everybody's purpose is not better than the next. So your purpose isn't better than her purpose, but your purpose is different than his, and his is different than hers, and your guys is different than theirs. Nobody's purpose is bigger than the next person's purpose. Just because you're an athlete doesn't make you better than an artist or a musician. It doesn't work like that. Because everybody has a different purpose and everybody has a different gift to give to this world. Just because someone does something different than you doesn't make you better than them. Because some, quite frankly, that person does something a lot better than you do. We all have flaws. I have flaws. You have flaws. You have flaws. Everybody has flaws. Nobody's better. Nobody's bigger than the next person. It doesn't work like that. That's not how society works. That's what society tells you, but it's not like that. The next thing that goes with being the best you, and probably if there's one thing that you will take from this, from what I'm talking about, is knowing your why. Why are you doing what you're doing? You guys play sports, I assume, yeah? Why do you guys play sports? You don't got an answer, but it's something to think about. Why do you do it? What's your reason? What's your reason to whatever you guys do? What's your reason to your passion? Whatever your passion is, why do you do it? Because at the end of the day, when you set these goals, when you reach challenges and obstacles and adversity, because 100% of the time, adversity is gonna show up all through your life. 100% of the time, it's gonna show up and it's gonna be there. And when you get to that point, you gotta know your why, because your why is gonna get you through that point. It's gonna get you over that hurdle. It's gonna help you persevere. It's gonna help you get through that adversity to reach your goals. So knowing your why. We have a thing in society, I mean, we live in social media. You got Twitter, you got Facebook, and you got Instagram, and you start comparing yourself to what other people have and what other people have. The only person you should compare yourself is who you were yesterday and to who you want to be. Those are the only two people you need to compare yourself with. Who you were yesterday, are you better than you were yesterday, and are you taking steps towards where you want to be, who you want to be in the future? Those are the only two people that you need to compare yourself. That's the only thing. So set your goals, create a purpose which creates energy, and most importantly, know your why. Now I want to open up to some questions. If you guys have some questions, don't be shy. See, my dude right there. My dog, he looked like he got his phone out. He was ready to ask some questions. Here, let me. I'm gonna come up to you so we can talk.
Look at me.
What's your name?
I'm Austin.
Everybody, this is Austin. If you didn't know him, what grade are you?
I'm a freshman.
He's a freshman. You stood up and you was. What's your question?
What was your motivation to get through college?
Go ahead.
What was your motivation to get through college?
What was my motivation to get through college? That's a good question. So he asked, what is my motivation to get through college? So when I got to college, you can ask Coach Miller, I was about 6 feet, about 175 pounds, about around there. And my motivation was, a lot of people told me I couldn't play college football. People told me that. People said that I wasn't going to be able to play Division I sports. And my motivation was to prove the people that supported me. I always say, I don't prove my doubters wrong. I like to prove my supporters right. And so when I got to college, I wanted to prove my supporters right. But when I got there and I actually got into the school, I had a group of friends, which this is actually very important right here. I had a group of friends that we got together and we told ourselves, like, look, we all have similar goals. We all have a similar mindset, and we're all gonna hold each other accountable to achieving our goals. So one thing I would say is surround yourself with people who have the same ambitions. Surround yourself with people who have the same goals, same mindset. Surround yourself with people who want to achieve the same things, because at the end of the day, those are the people that you're going to lean on, and those are going to be the people that help you get through that struggle, and they're going to hold you accountable. Being accountable to yourself and to your friends is important. It's important. Next question. What's your name?
Kyrie Thompson.
Kyrie Thompson. What grade are you in?
Sophomore.
Sophomore. All right, what's your question?
and I can ask you anything.
Now, look.
No.
Don't be out here asking crazy questions.
No, it's about the Seahawks.
Are you going to ask why did we throw the ball?
Yes,
on the
I'm going to ask you.
Yeah, you could give him one. I'm not surprised by that question. Look, I'm gonna answer your question. I don't call the plays. Amy's just gonna be throwing t-shirts. Look, to answer your question, I don't call the plays, I just run them. I can't give it. That's
the political answer.
You all right? Who got a question over here? My dude up there? Alma, come up. Let me squeeze in here with you guys. Hold on, scoot over. You ain't. What you mean? Hold on, let me sit.
All right.
What's your name?
My name's Ben.
Ben. What grade are you in?
I'm a junior.
Junior. What's your question?
Do you play fantasy football?
I don't play fantasy football. I know.
So I play fantasy football and you kind of only got me one touchdown.
It was a struggle, man. I told you, we hit adversity sometime, right? All right, who got some serious questions? Who got some serious? Let me get through. Who's got some? She's got one right here.
Okay.
Hold on, what's your name first? Hold on, I gotta hear the question. I gotta hear the question. Is it a legit? Are you gonna ask me about throwing footballs on 1 yard lines and? Okay.
If you hadn't have chosen football as a career, what would you have chosen?
Put me on the spot. Oh my gosh. That was. If I hadn't chosen football. What would have been the career that I have chosen? That's a really good question. So to answer that, so when I was younger, I guess I would have said I would want it to be, you looking at the t-shirt, you ain't even hearing the answer. It's all right. So if I didn't choose football, initially, when I was young, I wanted to be a police officer, so I guess that's kind of the area I would have went into. You not having fun? Nah? You having fun? I'm just checking. I'll come over here later. We'll go right here. All right, we'll come back. All right, let me hear a question. What's your name?
Alexia,
okay, what's your question?
What was your major in college?
Okay, she asked what was my major in college. So, here's the thing. I'm gonna tell you guys the truth about college, all right? I'm gonna tell you the truth. Hold on, I'll wait. So she asked what was my major in college? And this is the truth about college. So when you get to college, you think you want to major in certain things. So when I got to college, I was like, I'm about to major in political science. That's what I'm going to do. I took my first political science and I instantly knew it was not for me. Then I said I was going to do psychology. Took two classes of psychology, instantly knew it was not for me. So what I ended up doing, which I'm so glad I did, I was a sociology major. All right, I'm gonna do two more questions. My dude got a Kearse jersey on. I mean, you can't like pass him up.
Can I get a picture with you?
How's it?
No, I have a question.
All right. Hold on, what's your name?
Tony Pekkanen.
Oh, you got to say
Tony Pekkanen.
You're what, a sophomore, junior?
Sophomore.
Hold on, what's your question?
What is the hardest game of your career?
What do you mean by like hard? What define hard?
Toughest, closest game.
No, not the Cowboys. So he asked what was the hardest game of my career? Or the toughest? So to answer that, one of the hardest games of my career was against the Packers 2 years ago, NFC Championship. And I say this because if you look at the game, my first four targets were all interceptions. Just pick, first one happened, I was like, okay. Second one happened, I'm like, probably shouldn't check the Twitter after the game, probably shouldn't do that. Third one happened, I'm like, okay, probably gotta move out of Seattle. Fourth one happened, I'm like, okay, this is a dream. So, and I'll tell you why that was hard. I'm gonna tell you the reason why it was hard. It was not because of the picks. It was more so the mental toughness that I had to go through that. You throw four targets, you have four interceptions, I guarantee you a lot of people will break down and just give up, right? I told myself after the fourth one, I sat on the bench, I was sitting right next to Doug Baldwin. And I told myself not to feel sorry for myself. And like I said before, everybody's gonna go through, you're gonna go through adversity, you're gonna go through challenges. It's gonna show up 100% of the time, and you gotta go back to your why, right? And that's why I said your why is important. So I went back to my why. Why do I play the game, right? Dang. And I went back to my why. I told myself not to feel sorry for myself, and I went back to my why. My why was my family. And I thought about what I represented, all the times that people told me no, who I was, where I went, from where I started to where I got. And I went back to that, and that allowed me to go back, my fifth target, and make the most of the opportunity that I have, and it so happened to be the game winner to send us to the Super Bowl. Thank you for sure. All right, we got one more. We got one more. We're gonna go right here. Can I get through you guys right here? Can I get through? You guys are so kind. You guys are so, excuse me. Hold on, let me. All right, what's your name?
Haley.
Haley?
Yeah, Haley.
What grade are you in?
Freshman.
Yeah. I'm assuming that this is the freshman side, I'm assuming.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, what's your question?
Who was your biggest inspiration growing up?
All right. Okay, excuse me, guys. All right. She asked me who was my biggest inspiration growing up. Now, there was a lot of people that influenced. And come on, Amy, throw the t-shirts. I'm just kidding. There was a lot of people that influenced me and who set the example. But in high school, Mrs. Harrell's gonna probably laugh, but my older brother was like my huge inspiration of going through high school. He played all the sports. Miss Harrell would consider he was a popular guy, yeah. But he was a huge inspiration because Amy, go ahead, just throw them, Amy. Here, you might as well give me some. Here, but to answer the question, he was a huge inspiration because he... Okay. All right, stop throwing. Okay, throw one more. Okay, let me let me get back to the question. Let me get back to the question. All right, back to the question. He was a huge inspiration. He always led our house by example, and he always looked after us, and he showed a great example to me and my brothers. Here, I'm gonna throw these. I know there's a lot of questions. I can't get to all the questions. I want you guys to download that app, Star Time. I will be on Star Time to be able to answer all the questions that you guys have. Go on the App Store. It's called Star Time. I'll be on there later this week to be able to answer a lot of more of your guys' questions. I want to thank you guys for allowing me to come here and talk to you guys. And go Lancers. What's up?